Hey guys, this is Ulrich from Nostalgic Mathematics. Today we will try to solve a problem from the Israel National Olympiad 2015. Here we should decide whether a number is an integer or not. Actually, this number is a cube, so it may be interesting to focus on the number under the exponent, this one. Let's call this number A. We see that we have four numbers in A, which are cubic root of 77, cubic root of 75, cubic root of 5775, and the number 76. Actually, we're going to use the numbers in bold as reference because we want to express the numbers in blue and red in terms of those numbers. First, let's set x equals the cubic root of 75 and y is the cubic root of 77. So, we notice that 5775 is the multiplication of 75 and 77, and use x and y, we see that 5775 is the multiplication of x cubed and y cubed. Again, we notice that 76 is 77 plus 75 divided by 2. So replacing again, we see that 76 is x cubed plus y cubed divided by 2. With these informations, we replace in A, as you see, 76 is replaced here by x cubed plus y cubed divided by 2 at both places, and replace y here and x here and here. Again, cubic root of 5775 should be the product or the multiplication of x and y. That's what we have here. Now, we know how to factorize the expression x cubed plus y cubed. That's what we do. So it is factorized here and here. And we simplify. You see, because x cubed plus y cubed equals this multiplication. And here it is divided by y plus x. So it remains only this. This 2 was the 2 that we have here. So we rearrange the terms. We can isolate x plus y and put this difference, y minus x, here in the numerator. So what I want to do now is that we will try to figure out the candidates that are here and here. So let's start. Okay, so we know this expression, it is well known. It is based on the factorization of y cubed minus x cubed. It gives us this. The key here is that we could notice that y cubed minus x cubed is equal to, by definition, y cubed is 77 and x cubed is 75. So the difference between those two numbers is 2. Replacing again gives us that x squared plus xy plus y squared is 2 divided by the difference of y minus x. This is good. So we can deduce that the term here is equal to y minus x. So we just have to focus on this one. Okay, we do the same. Patiently, we do the development of y minus x multiplied by x squared minus xy plus y squared. So we have the different terms. This multiplication yield the term x squared y, x y squared, and y cubed. And here we have minus x cubed plus x squared y and minus x y squared. You see that we introduce the colors. So we're going to group the terms, and then we have y cubed minus x cubed plus 2 times minus x y squared plus x squared y. Nice. Okay, we used the numbers, I think the results, the outcome that we have here, since y cubed minus x cubed is 2. We replace here by 2, and that's good. we can factorize again by 2. And this multiplication equals 2 times y. I think 2 times 1 minus x y squared plus x squared y. So we rearrange again. So we divide it and we see that this term here equals 1. So using those two results, this and this, we can see that a will equal x plus y because this term equals 1. And we see that this one equals here y minus x. So a equals x plus y minus x. X and minus x will cancel out each other. So a equals 2 times y. We have established that a is equal to 2 times y, knowing that y is equal to the cubic root of 77. Raising to the power 3 yields a cubed is 8 times y cubed, or a cubed is 8 multiplied by 77. So we can conclude and say that a cubed is therefore an integral. And the right answer was then true. I thank you for attention. Do not forget to subscribe, to share, like, and comment. Bye.